Since the Legends Football League was formed in 2009, only three teams have brought home the Legends Cup. The Los Angeles Temptation. The Chicago Bliss. And the Seattle Mist. These are their stories. This is LFL Dynasties. When you look at the most successful dynasties in the history of sports, they all share many of the same attributes. But the most consistent of these attributes is strong and solid leadership at the top. Red Auerbach, Chuck Knoll, Al Arbor, Sir Alex Ferguson, and Bill Belichick all come readily to mind. In the LFL, no team embodied this more than Keith Hack's Chicago Bliss. Players came and players went, but year in and year out, the road to the Legends Cup always ran through the Windy City. The Bliss assured their place in LFL history by playing in the very first game in league history. This would set the tone for the next 9 years as they also recorded the very first LFL win of all time over Miami. In 2009-2010, the Bliss were the dominant team in the regular season, led by the tank Tasha Pryor. Chicago would cruise into Lingerie Bowl 7 with an unbeaten record, but they would ultimately be outlasted by Dave Bishop's LA Temptation. In spite of the disappointing loss in the Lingerie Bowl, Hack's Bliss saw how far they had come in just one season, but they also saw how far they needed to go.
Game day!
2010 saw the arrival of two stars that would define the first half of the LFL's 10-year history. While Ashley Salerno's enormous presence was being felt in Los Angeles, Heather, the rock star Fur, made a similar impact on the Bliss in 2010-2011. Fur would battle Salerno in two bitterly contested games that year, losing both, but Heather would take home league MVP honors at the end of the season. This leads to a question that I have for you. What do most rock stars do after hitting the big time? Simple. They get a Ferrari. ...2018 LFL Hall of Fame inductee Chris Dell the Ferrari Harris was more than another running back in a league dominated by the running game. She was a game-changer whose combination of speed, power, and balance made her the first true triple threat in LFL history. She was equally as dangerous as a deep threat as she was in the I formation. The Ferrari would not only go on to be one of the greatest players in LFL history, but also one of the league's most entertaining personalities.
Hey, I'm gonna show you how excited when you eat my pussy!
Wow!
Yes. That happened. In spite of the exploits of the Ferrari, the Bliss took a step backwards in 2011, missing the playoffs. There was clearly something still ailing the Bliss. Is there a doctor in the house? Dentist by day, superhero by night, Allie Alberts would prove to be the missing piece to Chicago's championship puzzle. While best known for her defensive abilities with the Bliss, Alberts was also a solid wide receiver. Combine that with her knack for showmanship, Allie would go on to be one of the most popular players in Blisstory.
Fucking roll, and let's go win this ball game.
2013 was a year of big changes for the LFL as they would undergo the first of a series of rebrands over their history. They would change their name from Lingerie Football League to the Legends Football League. The championship game would become known as the Legends Cup, retiring the Lingerie Bowl name, which dated back to 2004. The uniforms would undergo minor changes as well. Gone were the chokers and garters in favor of performance wear, although some didn't feel that much was changed there at all. The league also used a four-division format for the first time in their history, with an expanded playoff format that included a wild card game.
I've been waiting a year we've been practicing for this game, so it's time.
Leading up to this game, I have had dreams of just blasting through the A-gap and sacking Salerno, and I won't feel bad about it.
While the LFL was in midst of great change, it seemed like business as usual for the Bliss. They stumbled out of the gate suffering a 31-18 beatdown at the hands of the Temptation at home, extending their losing streak to LA dating back to 2009. But Hack was able to right the ship, and the Bliss would finish 3-1, good enough to win the Midwestern Division. Heather Furr took home her second LFL MVP award in 2013, while Keith Hack took home the league's Coach of the Year honors.
I think Heather Furr is overrated. We proved that the first time around. Tonight is no different. We're about to shut that shit down again.
The first round of the 2013 playoffs was another rematch between Chicago and LA. It was yet another barn burner from start to finish, with one big play after another. The Temptation went into the break with a punishing last-second touchdown, reminding the Bliss of a similar hit in their previous meeting. It was starting to look like a rerun of the same movie the Bliss had seen too many times before. Or so we thought. The Bliss responded by stopping Salerno dead in her tracks with a huge interception by Heather Furr. This set the stage for Christelle Harris to dominate LA's defense, tying the game after three quarters.
Play to Harris. Harris trying to cut outside, then inside. All that ducking and diving yields about 10 yards.
And now we come to one of the most pivotal moments in LFL history. In some ways, this one play represented the crossroads the league was at as a whole. A fading dynasty struggling to hang on in the face of an entire league changing around them, and another team struggling to break free to create a legacy of their own. What followed is a moment forever frozen in time. Enjoy.
Goal as Furr takes the snap, eluding the rush. Left-handed shovel to Christelle Harris. Unbelievable. What a playmaker. That had shades of Brett Favre all over it, Bobby.
Mitch, that might be the LFL play of the year. This is where Ashley Salerno usually goes into a world of her own and somehow comes up with something.
Now a 2nd and 4 from the LA 21. As Salerno drops back the pass, looking over the middle, now trying to buy some time, throws it across her body, and that is picked off by Heather Rockstar Furr. What an interception, and what a play for Chicago that could easily send them to the next level and possibly end the reign of LA.
A wise man once said, to be the man, you have to beat the man. After 4 years of frustration, the Bliss had finally done it. The torch was momentarily in the Bliss's hands, but now there was the small matter of running with it. The 2013 Western Final pitted Chicago against Chris Michelson's Seattle Mist. In spite of a 4-0 regular season, the Mist were no match for the Bliss, who cruised to a 31-14 win, sending them back to the LFL Championship game.
the veteran Philadelphia Passion returns to the biggest stage in football to take on MVP Heather Furr and the explosive Chicago Bliss. Tonight, a champion will be crowned. Legends Cup, next.
The 2013 Legends Cup Final featured two teams in search of redemption after years of frustration, the Chicago Bliss and three-time Eastern champions, the Philadelphia Passion. What was billed as a running backs duel between Christel Harris and Mary Rose Roach quickly turned into a mismatch as the Bliss dominated both sides of the ball from the start.
And first and 10 at the Philadelphia 12, end around reverse. This one goes to Alberts. Alberts on the edge. She's going to score. And that'll put Chicago up to an early 13-0 lead.
Chicago scored on their first two possessions before Chantel Taylor took a Christy Bell interception to the house and the rout was on. Allie Albert scored her second touchdown to give the Bliss a 27-6 lead at the break. The Passion struck right back to start the second half, but this was as close as they would get.
Outside cuts it inside, and she could be off to the races. Only Yashi Rice chasing, and Roach crosses over for six.
Wow, they came back with the exact same play. Another great call by Lance Smith.
Heather Furr ran for one more score for good measure, and the Legends Cup belonged to Chicago.
And we are just one simple kneel down away from crowning the Chicago Bliss your 2013 Legends Cup champions. And there's a look at Heather Furr, your league MVP, your game MVP, and now she takes the Ring of Champions trophy back to Chi-Town.
After 3 years of near misses, Keith Hack and the Bliss had finally won the big one. This would prove to be habit-forming as the torch was officially passed. The LFL was no longer ruled by the Temptation Nation and was now under the thumb of the Blissful Empire. And they were not about to let go. The Chicago Bliss went into the 2014 season looking to repeat as Legends Cup champions. But when it comes to being on top, Abby Lee Miller has some words of wisdom.
Like I tell everybody else, it's tough getting here. It's even more difficult to stay here.
With a big target on their backs and even bigger expectations, the Bliss did not disappoint. At their home opener, Chicago raised their first championship banner and followed it up with a statement win over LA, putting the entire LFL on notice. This was not going to be a one-year wonder. A high-scoring tie with the Seattle Mist was the only blemish on what would be an unbeaten season for Chicago. The 2014 Chicago Bliss boasted a loaded roster that was largely unchanged from the 2013 team. Heather Furr continued to dominate both sides of the ball. 2013 LFL Rookie of the Year Allie Alberts had another solid season in 2014. Chantel Taylor continued to shine as one of the best defensive players in the league. Dina Fagiano didn't get the ball very often, but when she did, big things happened. And Christel Harris continued to reign supreme as the 2014 Offensive Player of the Year. In the 2014 Western Final, the Bliss would once again face the Los Angeles Temptation. In what would turn out to be the final chapter of the Heather Furr Ashley Salerno saga, the Bliss cruised to a 40-12 win, sending Chicago back to the Legends Cup Final.
We've played in much bigger games than this. All right, we've prepared for much better opponents than this. All right, so let's go out and take care of business, show the East what the West is all about.
Yeah.
All right, and show the West that the time of the Bliss is now.
Yeah.
The The 2014 Legends Cup Finals saw the Bliss defend their title against Dane Robinson's Atlanta Steam, led by 18-year-old rookie sensation Dakota Hughes. This would mark the first of many classic playoff battles between these soon-to-be bitter rivals. The opening kickoff showed how nervous the Steam were playing in their first LFL title game. But they settled down quickly and nearly took a Heather Fur pass to the house on Chicago's first possession. But the Bliss would stop Hughes and Nas Johnson dead in their tracks with a huge goal line stand. Atlanta got not one, not two, not three, not four, but 8 chances at the Chicago goal line with a little help from a pass interference call, and the Bliss stopped the Steam every single time. On the ensuing drive, the Ferrari took over and ran the Steam into the ground en route to the first score of the night for Chicago.
First and goal at the Atlanta 5-yard line. Chicago hoping to break the scoreless tie, and they will right there. The Ferrari, Chrisdell Harris, 5 yards to the house. First blood for the Chicago Bliss in the Legends Cup.
Dakota Hughes led the Steam the length of the field in the closing moments of the half to cut Chicago's lead to 2 going into the break.
Fourth down since Atlanta has had tonight. None bigger than this. Fourth and goal. Nas Johnson. She's in. She's in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Huge turn of events right there.
The turning point came during Atlanta's first possession of the second half. Dakota Hughes threw a pass through a sea of hands before being caught by a wide-open Nas Johnson, who walked into the end zone for an apparent touchdown for Atlanta. The referee called the play incomplete, but replays showed that the ball clearly bounced off Coco Montgomery's foot and never actually hit the ground. Steam coach Dane Robinson protested, but never actually challenged the call. He would ultimately regret this decision. Regardless of the questionable officiating in this game, the Steam had no answers for Chrisdell Harris as the Ferrari ran wild on Atlanta all day. Hughes would finally get on track with a bomb to Coco Montgomery to bring the Steam within 4, but this was as close as Atlanta would get. The Steam attempted an onside kick, but that was yet another bounce that would go Chicago's way. The 2014 Legends Cup MVP Chrisdell Harris ran in one more touchdown for good measure, and Chicago's second straight Legends Cup title was theirs.
As the clock ticks down to 0, the confetti cannons fire in the air. The Chicago Bliss are back-to-back LFL USA Legends Cup champions.
It wasn't pretty, but the Chicago Bliss completed an unbeaten 5-0-1 season. This represented the peak of the Heather Fur era. But 2015 was the year the Bliss got real. Going into 2015, the Legends Football League landed a deal with the Oxygen Network. Was this a deal that would finally get their games broadcast live? Of course not. It was for a reality TV show, but I'll let Mitch Mortazza tell you all about it.
Hey, welcome fans. 3 years in the making, we finally have our reality partner in place. Signing the documents for it right now. A little bit of history in the making, so we thought LFL Films should bring you this moment right here and now. Here's the official signature. Everything's been completed. We're done. We're going into production. We'll be on TV next fall. Watch for LFL Reality.
The guinea pig for this experiment would be the 2-time Legends Cup champions. And Oxygen would follow the Bliss around all season, for better or for worse. The result would be gems like this.
True Chicago tradition, we got white girl wasted. I first met Ashley when she knocked me unconscious at my first LFL gig 2 years ago.
All of these ghetto, just got out of jail, bunch of bitches.
Why is there a vibrator on the chair?
I was experimenting.
It's just a vibrator. Ellie wasn't home, so the whole place was to me. Just throw it in the dishwasher. It's dishwasher friendly.
The last I checked, she liked the ping ping.
What?
You sick?
Yeah, she just farted on me.
You're literally so sick.
She farts every practice over and over again. It's absolutely ridiculous.
You are so gross.
Like, the smelliest farts I've ever smelled.
You are lying. My farts are the hardest thing.
So everybody has this joke about me, which is absolutely okay.
You should check your pants.
She might have sharted. It always smells like she sharted.
Yeah.
Everything is still on the inside. Come on, you gotta keep it classy.
Are you kidding me?
That's pretty much all you need to know about Pretty Strong. It would only last one season. Thank God. On the field, the Bliss improved on their 2014 campaign with a perfect 5-0 record during the regular season. Now, in spite of the fact that the league had five other teams that they could have played, they only scheduled them games against Omaha and Atlanta because reasons. Ultimately, the Bliss would come up short in their bid for a third title, losing a barn burner to Seattle in the Legends Cup final. This would be Heather Furr's last LFL game after five highly decorated seasons. There would be even more changes in the offseason as Chicago would be ground zero for an invasion.